The PSE index lost another 1.2% on Monday, joining a regional rout led by China Tech. This also ahead of the Banco Central's policy meeting this Thursday, where it's expected to stay on prudent pause for a third consecutive meeting. Joining us this morning, Luis Limlingan. He is head of sales at Regina Capital. Luis, good to see you. Hi.
Hi, good morning, Mimi. Nice to be back.
All right. So Luis, I want to begin by asking you about the very low volumes we're seeing. Why aren't traders jumping in on the valuation bandwagon? Is it because they think the market hasn't bottomed out yet? Is this a falling knife still?
Well, I don't think it's really how they're viewing the Philippines, but the global macroeconomic picture. Evidently, yesterday we saw what happened across Asia. There are concerns that there is a slowdown in China or maybe even a recession, given that the bank loans have tumbled. And then yesterday, I think one of the largest property developers, which is Country Garden, they suspended, 10 to 11 of their onshore bonds just yesterday. So they're worried about some restructuring that might be going on. Prior to that, I think there was also weak trading data that came out. It was below what analysts were projecting. Then, of course, the GDP figures weren't as encouraging as well. So now everyone is now focused on China. Yes, the Philippines is cheap, but I think their attention really is on the second largest economy right now and what's going to be happening in the coming weeks.
Mm-hmm. Because China, you know what they say, when the giant sneezes, the whole world, at least the neighbors, will catch a cold. So I wonder how you're making sense of where our market is today versus where the economy is. I mean, at 63.29, that's where we finished yesterday, it seems like sentiment today is worse than it was back in 2022, when inflation at that time, by the way, was still climbing, policy tightening was in high gear. But, you know, we're fundamentally speaking better off today. Why isn't the market better off today?
Well, the market prices the data that's available now in order to make a forecast of what's going to happen in the future. And originally, at the beginning of the year, there were only concerns of the U.S. going to recession. Those concerns are still lingering. And now you're already dealing what's happening to China, given that they also might be going into recession. In fact, they were saying that not just a recession, that the bigger concern might enter into a deflationary environment, which is much worse. So now it's not just the U.S. that you're focusing on, but also on China. Then, of course, the geopolitical concerns happening between Russia and Ukraine. I think there were some attacks recently on ports, and that's why oil spiked immediately. So all of these are, I guess, adding up right now, and that's why the market, again, as you were saying, it's counterintuitive. The Philippines is cheap. We're growing much better compared to the rest of Asia. In fact, versus last year, we're actually doing, in terms of what the companies are reporting, it's actually much better. But why is it cheap? This is what's happening abroad. And that's why, you know, we're actually becoming collateral damage in effect.
Collateral damage. I just wanted to bring in, we're 3 minutes into trade for the day. The PSE index managing to go up by 0.1%, 8.6337. What is the short-term view on the index? Do you think this is it? 63 is the floor, or is there more to go?
Well, I think, we might be retesting some lows. And towards the end of the week, I think the investors are going to be digesting the outcome of the Fed minutes, whether the Fed will be a bit more dovish than what they expected or still a bit hawkish. I think they're going to be interpreting each line just to see if it's going to be aligned with what everyone is or what analysts are projecting of how they're going to be dealing with policy rates moving forward. So that actually could make the market, depending on how it's going to influence. And of course, our BSP as well, they're taking into consideration on top of the inflation and peso, what the Fed is going to be doing. Because again, If they don't move in tandem, it might weaken the peso as well, so it doesn't make it as competitive. So they also have to take those into consideration.
Mm-hmm. So I guess the market is pricing in, you know, a prudent pause from the BSP this Thursday on pause at a 16-year high benchmark policy rate of 6.25%. What does a benchmark policy rate of 6.25% mean for yields at the stock market, its attractiveness and competitiveness, and for the listed companies?
Well, taking 6.25% at face value, it is attractive. But you also have to consider, one, what is inflation doing right now? Are you able to beat the market by parking it in your time deposits or anything offering 6 to 7%? Second, what are the rest of the peers doing? So if you're a fund manager, you consider the forex risk of buying into a Philippine or local debt versus parking it in the US, which was before traditionally much lower, but now it's almost at the same rate. So you juggle with these things and you make all these considerations. And probably if I'm a US fund manager, I might just consider just parking it in the meantime in the US, given that, again, my inflation is much lower right now. So it creates a much bigger interest rate differential. And second, I just want to remove all the country risk, especially if I'm not too familiar with a specific region or country.
That makes sense. All right, I think we're ready for your blind item. Talk to us about this stock that you're monitoring closely and that you like. Don't tell us. Just describe and leave reviewers to guess what this is. What do you have for us today?
Well, we chose this company because we still think it's worth looking into, perhaps buying during, you know, some market correction or weakness such as what we're experiencing this month. In fact, some say, does it still have some room for growth? We think so because it's trading at around 13 to 14% of our fair market value. The reason I say this is because for the year, it's actually been one of the top five best performers in the PSE. Month to date, there's some correction, so maybe there's a chance for investors to pick it up. Just to sort of narrow it down and give more clues to our viewers, this is actually the finance space, and it has a market cap of 750 billion pesos, more or less.
All right, we're just going to have to guess which stock this is. Luis, thank you so much. Always a pleasure to speak with you. Good to see you.
Thank you very much.
All right.